Hi everyone, welcome back to The Hangout with Abby Kimani, or if you're new here, welcome. So this is Motivation Monday, and because Mondays are usually like, you know, the meh day of the week, just Mondays are usually not enjoyable. So I hope to make your day brighter, and I hope that you enjoy this video and smile or laugh a few times. Today, I'm going to be talking about habits that you need to stop. And these are habits that I'm guilty of doing myself, and there are a lot of them. That's why I have this to help me, because wow, this video is going to be extremely interesting. So, number one, sleeping late. Now, I'm guilty of sleeping late, like really late. Really late. I used to sleep late to the point where like my brother like created a schedule for me to like start, I can sleep at like 9:30, and like before I used to sleep at like 11, because procrastinating is something I can do and I can perfect it. So I procrastinate my homework, I study late, and then I sleep late. So my boss was like, Abby, like you're human, you need to like sleep early. I was like, okay, you have to sleep at 9:30. So now the latest I sleep is 9:40, because like 9:30, 9:40. So yeah, not getting enough sleep can weaken your immune system, cause thinking issues, and lead to weight gain. So those are some of the problems. But also, do you know that if you don't sleep like at all, at first you feel like energized and you feel happy. If you feel really energized if you have no sleep at all, but then now after, I've forgotten the science behind it, but after a while you're going to crash, you're going to feel sleepy, you're not able to concentrate, like it's going to be like a whole mess. So sleep is really important, and actually every living being on the planet sleeps, so sleep is that important. And if you skip sleep or you sleep late, you're in for a lot of trouble. So number two is drinking enough water. Now, of course, 60% of our body is made out of water, so it's obviously like, you know, beneficial. So staying hydrated helps to keep your memory sharp, your mood stable, and your motivation intact. Keeping up with your fluids helps your skin stay supple, your body cool down when it's hot, allows your muscles and joints to work better, and helps clean toxins from your body via your kidneys. So obviously drinking water has a lot of benefits. An adult male should have about 12 glasses of water per day, and an adult female like 9 glasses of water per day. But a good way to keep track is the color of your urine. If it's like light yellow, then you're hydrated well enough. If it's dark, just drink a lot of water. And if it's like completely clear, then you're drinking too much water. Yes, it's a thing, it's too much water. It doesn't really have problems except like bloating, but just reduce on the amount of water. So drinking water has a lot of benefits, and staying hydrated definitely helps, and it makes your skin stay young. So if you want to look young, then you know what to do. Number two is, the editor has already put, so thank you editor. Not getting enough exercise. I've not exercised in a while actually, and by a while I mean like 2 months. Yeah, I know, it's so long. But there are obviously like, you know, a lot of problems. So physical activity has, you know, a lot of health benefits, so many, the list is endless. It keeps you like looking and feeling good. Exercising regularly can help you lose weight and boost your energy. It helps you live longer. It helps keep your heart healthy, and like what's it called, prevent chronic diseases. So exercise has a lot of benefits, honestly, and not getting enough exercise can cause a lot of problems. So make sure you get at least, you know, an hour or so of exercise. That should be enough, I feel, every day. Or you skip like a day or something, like today, Monday you do, Tuesday you don't, Wednesday you do, Thursday you don't. But it really depends on like you and like your time, how much time you have available, a lot of factors, okay? So another thing is eating too much sodium. and mostly like, you know, sodium comes in form of salt. But on average, people, but these are Americans. So Americans on average eat about 1,000 milligrams more sodium each day than they should. One of the easiest ways to cut your sodium intake is to cook at home using fresh ingredients. And also, instead of adding salt to flavor stuff, try adding herbs. Yeah, herbs, not herbs. English is scary. So try adding herbs instead of salt. Because salt, it's dangerous, you know. And especially, by the way, not only salt, but sugar. Sugar is, what's it called? It's the deadliest metabolic poison. Like, can you imagine? Sugar is so toxic. It's so bad. There are so many problems with sugar. And the way it tastes so sweet to some people. Honestly, people have the amount of sugar that they can handle. And mine is really small. So if I take like a certain amount of sugar, I'm going to get a sore throat. I'm going to feel sick. I'm going to feel like vomiting. And I've just taken sugar. So my sugar intake is really low. And not, okay, you know what I mean, okay? And a lot of people, like, you know, they love sweet things. They have a sweet tooth, cake, donuts, everything sweet, like, they, you call them for it. So I'm not really, I'm more of leaning to the savory side of stuff. But long story short, sugar is really dangerous. Once you take sugar, your immunity, like, drops. So sugar has a lot of problems. Try and cut down on your sugar intake, because sugar is just like, So another thing is skipping breakfast. And I know so many people do this, especially school students, and I'm guilty of doing this. Because sometimes I don't feel like taking breakfast, so I don't take and I go to school and I'm fine. Maybe I'll be like a bit more hungrier than usual before break, but I'm usually fine. But there are so many problems with skipping breakfast. And this one friend of mine told me, they were like, oh, I'm skipping breakfast because, you know, I'm trying to lose weight. I want to get abs. Oh, wait, they might be watching this video. Sorry. It's just that, do you know, when you skip your breakfast regularly, there are, you know, many problems with it. And one of them is actually, I couldn't find, like, the reason. But I've just forgotten actually. But it actually, you actually add weight when you skip breakfast, for some science behind it. But long story short, the more you skip breakfast, the more weight you add. So if you're skipping breakfast because you're trying to like lose weight, it's like you're making it worse, okay? Just take your breakfast. Breakfast is the most important meal of the day. It's going to help you a lot, okay? And if you don't take breakfast, at some time during the day, you might feel like too hungry and take a snack at a time you don't really take a snack. And I'm sure that snack going to be an apple or carrots or a cucumber. It's going to be something like unhealthy or greasy, and it's something that, you know, you might not wanna like take. So those are bad habits that you need to stop. And personally for me, a bad habit is not wearing slippers. I'm almost always barefoot in the house. Where are my slippers? Oh, I know where my slippers are. But usually, I know where my slippers are, but I don't wear them. I walk around the house barefoot. And now I have a cold. But it's... But long story short, I need to start wearing my slippers. And if you walk barefoot, please wear your slippers too. And not only that, at getting sick, but because someone might drop like a plate or something with glass, and you step on the glass and yikes. Or a pin, or there's a risk of something entering your leg or piercing your leg that wouldn't be there if you wore your slippers. So that's it for today's video. I hope that you have learned something new and realized that you need to stop doing that bad habit. But otherwise, I hope you enjoyed this video. Please do like if this helped you. And I'll see you guys on the next one. And also, please comment down below if you've forgotten any other bad habit that people do a lot and is dangerous. I'll see you guys next time. Bye!